Let's start with today's class. So the lecture that we are going to focus on today is first order circuits, lecture 6. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the transient analysis. So first, we are going to define what is transient is all about. So first, you should know that what is transient. So generally, we will study in this circuit the combination of sources, switches, resistance, inductance, and capacitance. Now you see, so we have the passive components, resistance, inductance, and capacitance. Active component is the source, and something which is known as the switch will come, which will lead to the phenomena of transient. So the time varying currents and voltages resulting from the sudden application of source, usually due to switching applications, are known as transient. So we have the sources and switches. So what happened that in a circuit, when you have a sudden application, this is momentary application of the source with the sudden closing or opening of the switch, that lead to the transient. So the current and voltage will vary during the transient condition. In transient analysis, we will start by writing the circuit equations using the developed concept that we have studied, that is Kirchhoff's current law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, node voltage analysis, and mesh current analysis. So in order to write the equation for the transient, we should have a clear understanding of the concept that we have studied before. The current voltage relationship for inductances and capacitances involve integrals and derivatives. We have seen that when there is the introduction of inductance and capacitance, the current voltage relationship takes the integral and derivative term, which means that there will be integral differential equation coming when you write the equation. These equations can be converted to a pure differential equation. So we have to convert the equation in the form of pure differential equation by differentiating with respect to time. So the integral term, whatever the integral term is there, that you have to convert to the differential term. So you should have only the differential term so that we get a pure differential equation in the transient analysis. Thus, the study of transient requires us to solve the differential equations. So if you do not have well understanding of the differential equation, or you have forgot the concept, please revise it, because the differential equation is very important to understand the transient phenomenon. Because all the solution will depend whether we have a clear understanding of the differential equation or not. So when we study the transient, we are basically converting the current voltage relationship of the various components, which are inductance and capacitance, in the form of differential equation, and then solve the problem using writing the equations for different analysis concept. Now we'll start the first order circuit. Now why it is said to be first order, we'll see that. So a first order circuit can only contain one energy storage element, either a capacitor or an inductor. So first we will discuss first order circuit, and then we will go to the second order circuit. So by definition, first order circuit will have only one energy storage element, either the inductor or the capacitor. If you have the combination of LC, then it is known as the second order circuit, means two energy storage element is there. However, the circuit will contain resistance. So you will be having a circuit combination of RL or circuit combination of RC to form the first order circuit. So as I said, that the types of circuit that will lead to the formation of first order circuit will be the RC circuit and the RL circuit. So we will discuss the RC circuit and the RL circuit, starting from the RC circuit first and moving to the RL circuit. The first order circuits are characterized by the first order differential equation. So we have seen that the transient analysis, we required the differential equation to solve. And since the circuit is first order, having one energy storage element, we need to solve the first order differential equation. Now, before that, let us study first what is excitation of the circuit in the first order. So there are two ways by which you can excite the circuit. Excite the circuit means you are applying a source. So when you are applying a source, so that there is an energy transfer in the circuit, that is known as excitation. So the first way is source-free or natural response. So out of the two ways of excitation, the first way is the source-free or the natural response. There is no source in the circuit. Then what is the meaning of that? We'll see. Generally, the energy storage element may have some initial condition. What is the initial condition? Initial condition is the initial energy that is stored in the capacitive or inductive element. So a capacitor may be previously charged, or an inductor may contain initial current, so that are stored in the circuit during the initial condition. The energy causes the current to flow in the circuit, and then gradually it dissipates in the resistor, because you will be having a combination of RL or combination of RC circuit. So inductor and capacitor, which are initially charged or having initial energy, will dissipate its energy in the resistance after some time. Although we are taking source-free circuit, by definition, free of independent sources. So there will not be any independent source in the circuit. That is the reason it is known as source-free circuit. Source-free means we will not have any independent sources. Only the energy which is present in the inductor or capacitor, that will result in the current to flow. But they may have dependent sources. So a circuit which is independent, which is free from the independent sources, but have dependent sources, is a part of a source-free circuit. So the responses, that is the voltage or the current that we are going to compute for a circuit which is free of independent sources, and the energy is stored in the inductor or a capacitor, is known as the natural response. So this is the first way of excitation. The second way is the forced response. So when we say that source-free or natural response, or the forced response. Forced response means that you are having independent sources in the circuit, whether it is a voltage source or the current source. So that is a part of a forced response. Now, what type of sources can be there? The source can be DC source, sinusoidal source, excited exponential source, and step response. So these sources we are going to study one by one to understand that what will happen when we apply the source in the circuit and the transient occur for the circuit, and we will determine the voltage current of the circuit. So the two types of first order circuit, what are the two types of first order circuit? One is RL circuit and another is RC circuit. These are the two types of first order circuit, and there are two ways of exciting them. What are the two ways? One is source free and another is forced response. So basically they combine together to form four possible combinations. So there will be four possible combinations that we need to study. So our lecture focus for today's class will be the source free RC circuit. The meaning is that we are going to determine the natural response where there is no source in the circuit, and the circuit that we have chosen is the RC circuit, which is the first order. So we'll start our discussion on this. So a source-free RC circuit we have taken. What it means that it is independent of, it is not containing any independent sources. So you have a capacitor and a resistor, which is a part of a circuit, and there is no sources present or the independent sources present. But in order to understand that, it means that the capacitor is having an initial voltage. So at time t equal to zero, the voltage of the capacitor is V naught. So this voltage at time t equal to 0, the voltage V naught might have come from some DC source which was connected previously, but later it is disconnected. Means the capacitor which is charged to a voltage V naught at some time, after that it is disconnected, the source is disconnected, and now the potential which is present in the capacitor will be dissipated in the resistor. So we will discuss the source free RC circuit. So the energy which is stored in the capacitor will now release to the resistor. So the energy will be flowing from the capacitor to the resistor and it will dissipate. Now understand one thing, this circuit may look very simple, but it may be the part of a very complex circuit. So here the C, whatever we are talking about, the capacitor, that is C equivalent or the part of a complex circuit. The R also is a part of a complex circuit, which is equal to R equivalent of that complex circuit. So that a complex big circuit is broken down into a combination of C equivalent and R equivalent, where there is no independent sources present, and the energy which is present in the capacitor will be dissipated in the resistor. So let us describe the natural response of the RC circuit or the voltage current relationship of the RC circuit under the source free condition. So the capacitor is having an initial condition at time t equal to 0, which is equal to V naught. Means V naught is the voltage which is present in the capacitor at time t equal to 0. What is the meaning? The initial energy that is present in the capacitor is half C V naught square. So we know that the energy present in the capacitor, we take half C V square. So at time t equal to 0, the energy of the capacitor will be equal to half C V naught square, because V naught is the initial condition. Now at this particular node, if we apply the KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, then we know that the current is splitted into the capacitive current and the resistive current. However, there is no current source, so IC plus IR will be equal to 0 in accordance with the Kirchhoff's current law. We know that the capacitor current is equal to C dV by dt. This we have derived. We also know that from the Ohm's law, the resistive current is equal to the potential divided by the resistance R. So we substitute the value of IC and IR in the equation. Now this equation can be converted into a standard differential equation form. So a standard differential equation form can be converted by first making it independent, the differential term dV by dt, make it independent of the coefficient. So we divide the R with C, we get dV by dt plus V by RC equal to 0, and then finally we can write an equation dV by V is equal to 1 minus 1 by RC into dt. So this is the standard form of the first order differential equation. So this is, you can see, we have only one term. If you have d2y by dx square, then that is second order. You have dy by dx, that is first order. So here our variable is the voltage. So we are getting dv by dt as the term, right? So we have a first order differential equation. Now, the first order differential equation, the standard solution we know. So the solution is ln of v, v being the variable, is equal to minus t by rc plus ln of a. Now this a is basically the constant which is coming up from the differential equation. So if we take the constant in the other side, we can write ln v by a is equal to minus t by rc, or otherwise the solution can be obtained in time domain as v of t is equal to a e to the power minus t by rc. Now in this equation, so we have started from our discussion from t equal to 0, and we have reached at a particular time t what is the voltage equation. So voltage equation is A into E minus T by RC. So the unknown that we have in this equation is basically the constant A, which we have to get. Otherwise, the value of R and C we know, and T is the time in the equation. So how to get that constant A? So we have to apply the boundary condition. So boundary condition is that the voltage at time t equal to 0 is the boundary condition, voltage time t equal to 0, that is equal to V naught. So V naught is the voltage at time t equal to 0, that is equal to the value of A, because when we substitute here V of 0, we will get A into E, e to the power 0, which is equal to 1. So we'll get A. So V naught is equal to A. Now, then the final equation of the voltage that we are going to get for the RC circuit, source free RC circuit, is V naught e to the power minus T by RC. This equation need to be remembered. So please remember this equation, because this you have to solve the problems where you will require this formula to be remembered. So V of T is equal to V naught e to the power minus T by RC, where V naught is the initial voltage of the capacitor and T being the time at which you are calculating, and R and C are the resistance. So we can see from this equation that the voltage response of the RC circuit is an exponential decay of the initial voltage. So from the initial voltage V naught, there is an exponential decay because you have a negative term here, and the voltage will be reducing. So if we draw the graph of Vt, which is equal to V naught e to the power minus T by RC, we are getting a graph like this, which is starting from a potential V naught, that is the initial condition. So the graph is drawn between voltage and time, and there is an exponential decay in the graph. Now, at time t equal to 0, the potential Vt is equal to V naught. We can easily see that here we have V naught, which is at time t equal to 0, which validates that this graph is correct. What will happen for the increase in the time? So when we increase the time, the voltage will be reduced, and that will be moved to some value of 0, right? It means that the entire energy which is present in the capacitor is dissipated in the resistor. So through the resistor, it will be dissipated. So the voltage finally at the steady state condition will reach to 0. Now, we will introduce one term which is known as time constant, given by tau as the symbol. The rapidity with which the voltage decreases is expressed in terms of the time constant. So time constant is the rapidity with which the voltage is decreases. So the definition of time constant is the time required for the response to decay to a factor of 1 by E, or 36.8% of its initial value. That is known as the time constant. So it is a measure of a rapidity of the decrease, and the decay is 1 by E, or 36.8% of the initial voltage. So initial voltage V naught is here. At a time constant tau, where the voltage magnitude is 36.8%, which is 0.368 of V naught. So that is being given by tau. So tau is the time constant. So if you see the equation, we have improved the equation, and there is no RC term here. So RC term has been removed from the circuit, and tau term has come in the circuit. So we take that, how we have taken this tau. So let us see that. What is happening at t equal to tau means when the time is equal to time constant. So our voltage equation is V naught e to the power minus t by tau by RC, because you have taken the time in the equation as equal to tau. So you are getting e to the power minus 1, because your tau is equal to RC. So RC and RC will cancel out each other, and it will be equal to e to the power minus 1, which gives you to be 0.368 of V naught. So we will take the time constant of the circuit, RC circuit, is equal to R into C. So this is the time constant, and it is a measure of the rapidity with which the voltage is decreased, and the voltage is decreased to 36.8% of the initial voltage. Therefore, we have taken the tau value is equal to RC. Now we can improve the equation which we were having. So we were having an equation V of t is equal to V naught, which is the initial voltage, e to the power minus t by RC. So these RC value we have substituted to tau, because tau is equal to RC being the time constant. So this is the final equation that we have got for the voltage. Now let us see what is happening when we are increasing the time from a different point, that is tau, 2 tau, 3 tau, 4 tau and 5 tau. Let us see. So if I divide the voltage V of t with V naught, because V naught is a constant term, we take it on the other side, we are getting exponential decaying term e to the power minus t by tau. So when we put the value of t is equal to tau, we have got the Vt by V naught is equal to 0.36788. If we put the value of t is equal to 2 tau in the equation, we'll get 0.13534. So these values can be obtained from the calculator. You use the calculator and you obtain it. If we convert these into percentage, what we are getting? So the first one we are getting 36.8%, right? And here if we see it, at this point, we will get a percentage of, you know, it will be having 1.8%. It means if we split this time constant, so we are getting after 5 tau, the voltage V of t by V naught has reduced less than 1%. So less than 1%, it has come at a value of 5 tau. Now, what is the importance of that? That we are going to describe you a little bit later. Now, generally what happens is that if you have a RC circuit and you just take the voltage measurement V by V naught with respect to tau and draw the graph, so you'll get an exponential decaying graph with the magnitude 1, because we have normalized it, 1 we have here, then at time constant tau, that is tau, we having a magnitude of 36.8%, that is 0.37, and this is coming as the slope of this graph. If you have an exponential decaying graph, the slope of that graph where it is intersecting the x-axis, that is the time axis, is basically that tau tau, okay, the time constant tau. Now if we intersect that tau in the voltage equation, you will get this to be 36.8% of the initial voltage. So this is the way by which in a laboratory they measure the value of tau. So you draw the graph and take the exponential, take the slope and intersect with the x-axis, and then you can determine what is the value of tau. Now what I was discussing is that when the time has reached 5 tau, the voltage is less than 1%. So V of t is less than 1% for V naught after 5 tau. So when the 5 tau has crossed, the voltage has reduced less than 1%. Thus, it is customary to assume that the capacitor is fully discharged or charged after 5 time constant. So 5 time constant is taken as the time with which the capacitor will be fully discharged or it will be fully charged. It means that if you know the value of R and C in the network, you can determine tau, which is equal to product of RC. Then 5 tau is the time which will be required for the capacitor to fully discharge or fully charge. In other words, what we can say that the time of 5 tau for a circuit is the time to reach its final or steady state. So when you have a transient in the circuit, after 5 tau, your circuit will reach to a steady state. So this is very important for a design engineer to understand that if there is a sudden increase of the current due to the switching application, which is known as transient, so when the current will die out or when the steady state will reach, so steady state will reach at a time of 5 time constant. Now also you can see from this table that every time constant interval tau, so every tau time interval if you compare, you will be getting that voltage is reduced by 36.8% of its previous value. So if you compare these two values and these two values, every values you will see that there is a dip in the voltage of 36.8% of its previous value. So that is the importance of the time constant. Now if we draw the graph or V by V naught with respect to time for different time constant, tau equal to 2, tau equal to 1 and tau equal to 0.5. So our time constant is decreased in this way. So what is we are going to observe is that smaller the time constant, the more rapidity the voltage decreases. So the time constant, if it is very low, then the circuit will reduce its voltage very fast and the response to reach the steady state will be very fast in the circuit. So obviously your time constant has to be low, then only the transient will decay out fast and you will reach to the steady state. It reaches the steady state or the final state quickly due to quick dissipation of the energy stored. So time constant is low, it means that the energy which is present in the capacitor is dissipated in the resistor very quickly and the circuit has reached to its final state. Now we have derived an equation of V of t, that is equal to V naught e to the power minus t by tau, tau being the time constant which is equal to RC in the network. So we have to determine other terms in the circuit. So we have a resistor and capacitor we have. So we have determined the voltage V of t. Now can we determine the current which is dissipated in the resistor? So current dissipated in the resistor, because the voltage will be, they both are in parallel, so voltage will be constant. Then V of t by R will give you the current which is dissipated in the resistor, or the current which is flowing in the resistor. Now if you divide this equation V of t with R, then you will get the current flowing through the resistor R. Similarly, the power which is dissipated is voltage multiplied with the current. So we have obtained the current equation, we have the voltage equation, multiply both, so you are getting V naught square by R e to the power minus 2t by tau. So the energy which is dissipated in the resistor now is the integral of the power equation from time initial 0 to final time t. Put the value of the power equation here and integrate the equation putting the initial condition 0 to final time tau t, then you will be getting the equation of the energy as half C V naught square 1 minus e to the power minus 2t by tau, where tau is equal to RC in the network. So we have got the current, power and the energy in the circuit from the knowledge of the voltage equation for the RC circuit. What is happening at time t equal to infinity? So when the time has reached to infinity time, there is nothing called infinity, it means a long duration of the time. What is happening? So if I substitute the time t equal to infinity in the energy equation, so I'll be getting this term as Dennis's, which is equal to 0, and I will get half C V naught square, which is same as the energy at time t equal to 0, that is the energy initially stored in the capacitor. So the circuit has reached to its steady state at time t equal to infinity, which is equal to half C V naught square. The energy that was initially stored in the capacitor is eventually dissipated in the resistor. So whatever the energy it was having in the capacitor initially, that is half C V naught square, This was the energy which was present in the capacitor initially at time t equal to 0. That energy in the resistor is totally dissipated at time t equal to infinity. It means the capacitor is fully discharged. Now we'll see the problem solving steps. When we have a RC problem, that is the source free problem with a capacitor and a resistor in the network, then how do we solve those problems? So if you remember the steps, it will be easy for you to solve the problem. So first you have to determine what is the capacitor initial voltage, V of 0 equal to V naught. This is what, if it is given in the problem, then the problem solving become easy. However, if it is not given in the problem, the first you have to determine that at time t equal to 0, what is the initial voltage of the capacitor. Now you may ask me a question that we have studied the RC circuit, it should be given in the question. No, it is not like that. Let me draw a question, circuit to make you understand what is happening. So suppose you have a voltage of 10 volt, then it is a switch is there in the network. You have a resistor, you have a capacitor, then you have a resistor, you have a capacitor. Okay, suppose I take one example in the network. So what is happening? The switch was closed for a long duration of time, and the switch has opened at time t equal to 0. It means at time t equal to 0, this part of the network is disconnected. So this part of the network is disconnected from the rest part of the circuit because of the opening of the switch. In that case, your second part of the circuit, you have to obtain one capacitor and one resistor, which is, I said in the first slide, that you have to obtain C equivalent and R equivalent of the network. In that case, what is the potential V naught at the initial condition, that is at time t equal to 0, you have to obtain. So that is the first problem solving step, that we have to obtain the potential at time t equal to 0. Next, you will be determining the time constant tau. You know that time constant tau is equal to RC. However, for a complex network, your R will be converted to R equivalent and C will be converted to C equivalent. Now, R equivalent is converted to R Thevenin. So you have to apply the R Thevenin rule, because you have seen that the complex network is removed from the circuit. So basically you need the Thevenin resistance, which is the equivalent resistance of the network. So you have to determine the time constant tau very appropriately. Then you have to determine the voltage of the capacitor Vc of t, which is V of t. And you know that the fundamental equation is the initial voltage V naught into e to the power minus t by tau. This is the most standard equation for the RC circuit, source free circuit, or the natural response. When we talk about the source free natural response of the circuit, this is the capacitor voltage or the net voltage at time t. Once you have got the capacitor voltage, other variables, that is the capacitor current or the resistor voltage, resistor current, can be easily solved, that we have seen in the previous slide, that because both are parallel to each other. So if you know this voltage, other terms you can easily obtain in terms of Kirchhoff's current law and the normal Ohm's law. You can use it to find that. Now that here the time constant tau, again I'm saying time constant tau is equal to RC, where R will be converted to R Thevenin, that is the Thevenin equivalent resistance at the terminal when the capacitor is taken out from the circuit, then R equal to R Thevenin. So you have seen that in the Thevenin circuit, how we compute the R Thevenin. So that will be a very important part here to calculate the value of tau in the equation. Now, having known the steps, we will solve one problem and try to understand what is the way by which we can compute the transient condition for the RC circuit. So this is the circuit, original circuit that I'm having. It is given in the problem that the capacitor voltage at time t equal to 0 is equal to 15 volt. Because every time we start our discussion from a simple circuit, and then we can go to the higher circuit, complex circuit in the tutorial problems. So just for the understanding here, the capacitor voltage is equal to 15 volt, which is the initial condition. Many times this will not be given. A complex circuit will be there where you need to determine it. However, for the simple circuit, it is given. Determine the capacitor voltage Vc, the voltage Vx, Vx means the voltage of the resistor, and Ix, which is the current that is flowing through the resistor at time t equal to greater than 0. So what is happening for time t greater than 0, or the condition V of t, means the general solution you have to obtain. Now you know that we will start our solution from the capacitor voltage at time t equal to 0 is equal to the voltage at time t equal to 0, which is the initial condition, into e to the power minus t by tau, where tau is equal to RC of the network, and R being the R Thevenin that we need to calculate, and C being the C equivalent in the network. Now in this network there is only one capacitor, so your C equivalent is only C in the network, so there is no problem at all. However, we need to calculate the R Thevenin to determine the value of tau. So this circuit will be modified here by replacing the capacitor. So capacitor you replace from the circuit, and you just connect the potential, which is because we have to find the voltage of this capacitor first, Vc at time t equal to 0. So we need to determine the R equivalent, which is equal to R Thevenin in the network. This is R Thevenin, and this is your capacitor, which is already present in the network. So we have taken the capacitor here. So R Thevenin, how we are calculating? So R Thevenin we have to calculate, that is the equivalent resistor of the network. So if I remove the capacitor from the network, then these two resistors will come in series, that is the 12 ohm and 8 ohm resistor will be coming in series, and that will be in parallel with the 5 ohm resistor, because we have an open circuit here. We have removed the capacitor. That is the R equivalent at the capacitor terminal we need to determine. So we know that two resistors, when it is in parallel, the total resistance is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So R1 is 20 ohms, R2 is 5 ohms, and R1 plus R2 is 20 plus 5, which gives us to be 4 ohms as the net equivalent resistance or the Thevenin resistance at the capacitor terminal. Now this open circuit, which is at the capacitor terminal, we just reconnect the capacitor again back, and now our circuit is normal, R equivalent and the capacitor circuit. So it is easy for us to calculate the time constant now. So time constant is equal to R equivalent into C, where R equivalent we have obtained as 4 ohms. Multiplied with C, there is only one capacitor in the network, which is 0.1 farad. So we are getting 0.4 second as the time constant. Now the things will be pretty easy because we have got the time constant. So the voltage equation, we know that it is equal to V naught e to the power minus t by tau, where the potential of the capacitor in the initial condition, it is given to be 15 volt. So voltage V naught is equal to 15 volt, we have substituted, and tau, the time constant, is equal to 0.4, we have substituted. So we have got an equation, 15 e to the power minus t by 0.4 volt. That is the meaning that the capacitor voltage at time t is equal to 15 e to the power minus 2.5 t volt. This is the capacitor voltage at time t. Okay, now we have to find the voltage through the resistor of 12 ohms. So that is given. What is the voltage Vx? So voltage Vx, we can get it from the normal equation. Now we have got the capacitor voltage Vc. So we can apply the voltage division rule to get the voltage in the resistor Vx. So we can disconnect this part of the circuit, and we can obtain here that we know the voltage. So our circuit is this one, okay? So we have 12 ohms where the voltage is to be calculated. So we have taken in the numerator 12 ohms. In the denominator, R equivalent, that is 12 plus 8, that is 20, multiplied with the voltage of the capacitor, and we can get the value of Vx, which is equal to 9 e to the power minus 2.5 times the time t. Now finally, we have to obtain the current Ix. Ix we can obtain using the Ohm's law. So Ohm's law is voltage divided by the resistance. Voltage we have calculated, so we divide it with resistance, we'll get the current. So we can see that this is a very simple problem that we have taken to determine the transient condition of the first order RC circuit when there is no source in the circuit. And the initial condition of the capacitor is acting as a source which is dissipated in the resistor. So the equations we are trying to get for the different for the time V of t, the capacitor voltage first, and then we determine the current and the potential across the resistor. So this completes the first part of our discussion.